Namaskar student, today I am going to start chapter number 2, that is learn to use Microsoft Access. In this video we are going to learn about the data, what is a data, what is a database and what is a relational database management system, that is RDBMS. Let us see. What is a data? A computer is an electronic machine or device that processes data to give information. Data refers to raw facts and figures. This may be in the form of numbers, alphabet, images, sound or a combination of this. So, whenever you are writing something, like if I take an example of MS Word, what you are doing? You are writing a paragraph, right? That paragraph consists of a number, then the characters, then the alphabet. So, these are all what? Data, okay? It can be a number, it can be an alphabet, images, sound, or a combination of all of these. So, when I am giving a data, computer works on it, processes it and gives us the information. Now, what is a database? A collection of related tables with data is called a database. The data remains in an organized order in a database. Example are attendance register of your class. Second is a personal telephone directory. So, what is a database? Database means what? A collection of related tables with data. Okay, the data is kept in an organized manner in a database. If I take the example of the class register, what are there in the class register? Roll number, name, then the months according to the month and the date, present and absent are put by the class teacher. So, it gives us it is making the data more easily and in an organized manner so that we can more easily find it out who is absent on what date or in which month, right? So, this is a concept of a database. When we are organizing data in a form of table, a collection of related tables with data is called a database. And the data is kept in a very organized manner. You can easily find it out any data from the database. Now, advantages. What are the advantages of database? Easy retrieval of data, reduction of data inconsistency, easy sharing of data, easy manipulation of data and high data security. You can perform various kind of operation on a database like creation, deletion, modification and updation. So, database are very useful in maintaining the data. Now, what is a relational database management system? It is a collection of data item organized as a set of formally described tables. Data can be accessed or reassembled from these tables in different way without a need to reorganize the database table. And it was this concept was given by E.F. Codd at IBM in 1970. A relational database is a set of tables containing data fitted into some predefined categories. Okay, each table contains one or more data categories in columns and each row contains a unique instance of data for the categories defined by the column. Examples are Oracle, FoxPro and Microsoft Access. So, it is a set of tables that contain data fitted into some predefined categories. See over here. This is an example of relational model in DBMS. This is a database management system. Over here, you can see it is a collection of what? It is a set of table, right? Here you can see there are a set of tables containing a data fitted in a predefined categories. Like this is a category where the roll number and the name is put in this table. Again, in this table, I can see what is the categories, and it is categories of the course ID or column. The ID is given for the course. Then the subject name is given. So, in this manner, this table is created. Now, when this two table is related or is connected with the another table, see what it is forming? It is forming a new table. Over here, the roll number is there. It is connected with this table. Course ID is there, which is connected with this table. And I just added one more column, that is a marks. Using this roll number, what I can find, what is the name or whose roll number is roll number 1. What I can do? I can go to this table. I can see roll number 1, name is Arya, right? Then course ID, course ID is given, then if I want to find the course ID subject name, what I can do? I can go by this column course ID that is connected with this table. What I will get? I will get the subject name with this course ID that is a Java. That is IT101 is a Java. Same way IT102, I want to find it out that what is the roll number 1 name, what is the course ID name, IT course ID IT102 is given, but what is the name I don't know. Marks is, I created one more column, that is a marks, he got a marks as 99. So let me find it out from the other two table that is being created or that is being linked with this table. Roll number 1 name is Arya, then course ID 102 is C++ and the marks is given as 99. So what is happening without, what it is told that data can be accessed or reassembled from this table. What happened? I just accessed it. I just accessed this table, this two table, and I created another one table. Okay. Without need to reorganize the database table, what I have done, I just reassembled this two table in another table and I just created the marks column and I have put it out. Instead of adding all this together, I just created another one table, okay, and over there I just reassembled and added some data over there and I connected with other tables and I put a new column and made a new table which give me the marks of the some person or some person name or the course ID accordingly. So this is the concept of the relational model in database management system. So other example, let us see. See, this is the relational database management system. Two databases there, one is a student database, another is a course database. Using this two database, I created another one database that is a tech course. Okay, this tech course database is now connected or related with the other two table also. Okay, this table is related with the other two table, that is a student table and the courses table. Okay, so this is a example of a relational database management system. How they are related? I can see ID is given, then course ID is given and accordingly semester number is given, right? So if I want to find out the information about this ID 500, what I can do? As it is related with the student ID, ID column is, where did I got? I got this ID column from the student database table, right? So I can see 500 ID number 500 is about what is the name, then phone number, then date of birth. I can got it from here, from this table. Same way, if I want to find out the class ID of this student, that is, what is the class ID? 101. And I can see this is linked with the another table. I can get the information about this class ID if I get it this number. As it is linked with the another table, see what it is given, 101, title is introduction to informatics and the class number is 1101. So what I did is that I just reassembled this two table into another one table where I didn't included all this information together. I just took one column from here, one column from here, and I just added another one column. What is happening? And I created a relation between these two table with the new table. So what is happening? It is making the table much more easier to access. Using this relational database management system, we can easily share a data, you can easily connect it to with the other table and can make the work easier. Next one, see, participant table. Instead of putting all the more column, what I have done is that I took this ID column and the activity column. This ID column is linked with the student table and activity column is linked with the activities table. What is happening? If I want to find the information about this ID 084, it is, its activity is tennis, but what is its name and what is the cost of tennis? What I can do? I can see this ID column is linked with the student table. ID 084, name is John Smith, and tennis, if I want to find the cost, I can see it is linked over here. Here it is given, that is the $36. So this is the way we can create another database or a database without doing any changes, just connecting, just what you can tell, reassembling from this table and connecting with a new table. So this is a concept of a relational database management system. These are our database. I just connected with a new database and created a new table where it is giving an information about the other two table also, as they are linked with it. So this is the concept of the relational database management system. More examples are there. A typical business order entry database could include a table that describes a customer detail with column for name, address and phone number. Then all this software, we'll be learning about the Microsoft Access. It is about the relational database management system. We'll be learning it in the next class. In the next video, we are going to discuss about the database object. So this is the end of the video. Thank you. Namaskar.